client, we may have the access to view, edit, display, edit, create, but in the production client, for transactional data, master data, or even configuration or customization, okay, apart from your number range, okay, you will be having only the display access. Okay, now for number range also, you will be having the display access, but whenever you want to make any changes in the number range, okay, you will get a special authorization. You have to request a special authorization, which we call firefighter access. FF access, firefighter access.
Okay.
With the firefighter access, you will have the access to create. So with a proper approval, after getting a proper approval from your manager, from your or business, after getting a proper approval, then you will be given a firefighter access where you can go and manage the number range.
Okay.
Now to go to the configuration and customization field, type SPRO, that is stands for SAP project, and enter. Then click on SAP reference IMG. IMG stands for implementation guide. Then it will take you to the place where we can do all the configuration and customization. For few master data also we can create. Okay. So first is our enterprise structure. Okay, if you click on enterprise structure, it will not take you anywhere. If you click on the documentation, it will give you the theoretical part of your enterprise structure. It's a good documentation. Okay. For all the topic, what I will suggest, create a word where whenever you are going to a configuration, that specific topics documentation, keep it in a Word document, so that will be very helpful for your future.
Okay.
Before going to any other document, read once, it gives a really good exposure to the theoretical part, what exactly enterprise structure or whatever topic you go, it gives a good explanation, it gives you more deeper related to your SAP. Now, next to the documentation, there is a Dropbox. Okay, this is the Dropbox. Then I'm doing the definition, then the financial. Okay, here again we have defined company credit control area. So we have a documentation, then we have a IMG activity. So IMG activity is the place where we are going to define a specific company code, or you call it sometimes as a credit card. So this is one of the way to come to the specific configuration or customization. Another way is using the
T-code.
Transaction code. Okay, so for all the topics I have given the T-code, it is not required to remember all the topics T-code, but I'll suggest to remember first three topics. That is very important. There is no pattern, no systematic order. Okay, so you have to literally go and remember, or you can say that I had this thing. So first three topics are important. So try to remember first three topics. Other topics, it's not so important, but first three topics are very important. So whenever you are the easy access screen, you can directly type the T code, then it will take you to the place where particular company or work company or credit partner or T-code related to that specific configuration. Okay, so if you are not in the easy access screen, then you have to type slash N, then the T-code. For example, from credit partner, I want to go to a configuration of company code. If I type, I'm not now in the easy access screen, if I type only the T-code, it will not take you anywhere. So if you are not in the easy access screen and you want to use the T-code, then you have to type slash N, then the T-code. Okay, if you are not in the easy access screen, remember, you have to type slash N, then the T-code to open the new transaction. Second thing, at a time we can open Okay, if you type only /n without giving T code, it will take you to the easy access screen. For example, you are in some other screen, you want to go to the you want to go to the easy access screen, so you can type /n. Okay, at a time in SAP, like this session, 6 sessions we can open at a time. You create a session here. It is 4, 5, 6. So at a time, I can open 6 screens. Okay. Now here few important buttons. New entry, so whenever I'm creating a new item, new entries, copy as, delete, undo changes, select all, select block, and your display file. Here you have, if you want to display mode or edit mode. Now this is in edit mode. You want to switch to only display mode, we can click. Here we cannot change, this is just a display mode. So again click on the same item, you can do the change. This particular first button is for saving, so whenever I'm doing a configuration customization, I can do a control S or click on. Next one is for one step back. This is for exit the session. This is to cancel the. Then we have a find button, both, then first page, second page, previous page, next page, to move the different pages. Okay, you can use this particular. Okay, this is session, this is for generate of shortcuts, help documents, and your layout changes. Okay, when you go more and deeper, we will be using more and more these pages. Okay, so now let's say I'll define one trading partner. So, define partner. Let's I'll give AB 1000. Okay, so I have to say ABC private key. Okay, company name, name of company 2. If your company name is Lindier, we can update in the name of company 2. Sometimes some people, if their short name is there, sometimes what happens, they want to update their old name. Now they are given a new name, they want to remember the old name also, they use it, name of company. Sometimes what happens, even they don't want to use anything, but for requirement purpose, they want to do a, some kind of announcement and they want a specific information from the trading partner level. Let's say the rare registration number, okay, let's say the PIN number, sometimes we update that also, so that that information can be populated in a specific field and table, okay. Now, before going to this, another important information is that every configuration, customization, or transition data or master data, it is stored in fields and tables. How to know the fields and tables? Okay, for example, I want to know the fields and table where company, these identifications are stored. Click on F1 button. Go to your technical information. Okay. So the table name where it is stored is VT880 and the field name is RC. Okay. You want to view this table? I can. We can use a T code, correct, SC16, because this is another very important thing, tables and fields. I think
okay. So what is the significance of remembering all the tables for functions and children?
See, not all, you cannot remember all the tables. There are more than 10 million tables are there. But yes, few are very important, especially for three topics, then your master data, then few line items. You cannot remember all the tables. For tables,
not all the tables, but they ask you tables, like whether you know this table or that table.
For example, I need to do a customized report. Standard SAP does not provide a report. I want to do a customized report.
Okay.
Now, in the customized report, when we prepare a specific FS, so we have to mention, let me show you, we have to mention that in that report, the fields or tables. For example, I want to keep all my information related to line items, or from the line item a specific field I want to pick in my report. So then you have to tell them the tables and fields. So every time, not only this report, so any kind of report, any kind of enhancement you are doing also, then technical people, if you tell them a company, they will not understand. You have to tell them in your technical understanding, saying that, this pick this information from T880, company code, BUKRS, line item, your vendor master data, LFB1, KUKNR, your customer master data, you have to tell them technically. Probably this might have. For example, if you see processing logic, so not yet, this is not a this is just let me get customer lecture. So you have to tell the technical people the processing logic and from which table and field the information should be picked. So being a technical consultant, if you tell them a business area, he or she is very experienced, yes, they do understand. Otherwise, they want a FS where you have given the logic and you have given the tables and field. From which table, which field you want the information, if it is a report. If you are doing an announcement, what should be the logic? What should be picked first? What should be processed? What should be added or what should be deducted? If you are preparing a customized, you are preparing any kind of enhancement. So it is very important that we must remember most of the tables and fields. We cannot remember. I'll give you a list of tables and fields, and it gives the logic behind how it exactly works. I'll just explain you that. So you need not worry, I'll send all these documents, but not now. Little bit of time first. Send all these, you guys will get confused. So, but in the future, I'll send yes, this is. Now, let's this particular example. Okay, so your BA, very commonly we use BSAK, okay, to recruit, which gives us all the closed item. Okay, so under BSAK table, we have the information like company code, vendor, your clearing document, fiscal year, document, line item. Okay.
Okay.
Now, this is related, where we can find BSAK, we can find in BSEC. Now, for example, I want to club two table, BSAD, which is related to accounting secondary index for customer cleared items, and I want to club BSAK. These two I want to club. So when I'm clubbing it, okay, so system will check there should be a common field. In this thing, the common field is BUKRS. So I can club this. So when we prepare a report, we will tell the technical people, okay, you go to BSAK, look for BUKRS and which value, the value of your company code, and retrieve the data. Similarly, you go to BSAD, retrieve the data, put it in one Excel. The simplest report I'm telling. Where we club to Excel. Similarly, if you look for the more complicated one, then we give a more deeper logic. We say, okay, go to BSIK, then look for the fiscal year, then look for the line item, then go to BSAK, look for the clearing date, the range of clearing date, so for one period or two period or 1 year, then look for your document number. If document number start with a 6, 7 or 8 as per my requirement, then you look for the line item, then line item with a positive value or negative value. This is like more important. So every time we have to tell the technical people, go to the specific table and look for the specific. Because of that, we require tables and fields for our purpose. Okay.
Okay.
Vanessa, any question here? This is very important, actually, one of them.
No, nothing.
My question is, how much this is important from the, you know, interview point of view? Because
interview point of view.
They do ask.
Yes. So I'll suggest, remember like few of the things like your purchasing data, general data, these tables. Okay. What are the tables you are given here? If you see, you will find an around 100 or 110. So these tables, yes. If you are going as a fresher, fine. But if you are going as experienced people, you have to remember it. You do not have any other option. They do, some people they do art, some they don't.
Okay.
Okay. So, but what happens, like if you work in the SAP, it's very common that you will be working on these things frequently. So, it is expected that you should remember all these things.
Okay.
At least important one related to GL, related to customer master data, your asset, few items, for your cost center, profit center, internal orders, the basic tables you must remember.
Okay.
Okay.
So Kashi, you will give us this basic tables that, you know, because there are so many tables,
yes,
which we'll get confused. So at least, because we, I think we have to by heart them, because we don't know why terminology is given. So basic, like say as you said, purchase,
sure,
organization to FI, the during the integration, what are the basic tables that will,
yes,
exchange of information about. Okay. Yeah.
Definitely, I'll just note it on everything which are the important ones and I'll give it here.
Yeah,
around like 40-50 you can remember those things, which will be really easy.
Yeah, thank you.
Okay,
sure.
Now let's go to our configuration. Okay. company, company name, name of company 2, street, let's say NG Road, post box. I'm defining this company for India, so in India the postal code, post box always will be 6 digit. Okay, then city, let's say Bangalore. Okay. Now you see, when I click on the street, post box, postal code, city, there were not any drop box. These are open fields. That means I can give any information as per our requirement. But when I go to country, language, currency, there are drop boxes. That means you cannot give any input information apart from the listed ones. So whatever the country SAP is provided, we have to take those countries only. So as actually someone has defined this 10, but standard SAP provides 236 entries. Now, can we define our new own and country? Yes, we can define. For example, you are defining a country or implementing in a country where the this particular list does not contain that country, then you have to search for the SAP node. For every new country, okay, where SAP is included, they will provide a specific SAP nodes. Okay, those nodes will give you the details regarding the new country and the configurations related to new country. So once you find out if SAP has provided SAP node for a specific country, that means SAP is supporting for any company code defined in that particular country. Mm-hmm. Then that SAP node you have to be implemented. So simple thing, what you have to do, contact the SAP. Then they will give you the details in an SAP note. You have to bring and update this information in this particular configuration. If you see, I'll just show you one of the existing one for India. See all these fields: alternative key, number, name, nationality, vehicle, country. So all this information they will provide. Okay, important ones are your language, ISO code 3 characters, okay, and your country identification. These 5 items are important, rest all are not so important. Okay. Again, it can depends to your place, which particular reason you are defining. So again, it depends. If it's a European country, then you have to select a European country or not. Okay, so it depends, but you need not to worry. All the information will be provided in a SAP note. Okay, that those information, just you need to go to a new entry, update those information in these fields. Okay, so as of now, SAP provides 236 countries where they support, but yes, still if you find some places where our country is not listed in this particular list of SAP lists, then you can send a mail to SAP directly and saying that okay, you can first search in help.sap. if you find the SAP not good, if good, it is good. If you do not find, you can send your mail to SAP. If they do support, they will provide the SAP note. If they do not support, then you cannot implement the company for that particular company. Okay. Any questions on this?
For the SAP note, is it a technical implementation or how is it?
No, it's a configuration. It's a simple configuration. Okay. So applying of, okay, we can have a technical. If SAP notes gives say any coding part, then yes, it is a technical if it is a configuration, sometimes SAP node can be a configuration or customization also. So as a function of people, you can create it and put it in a TR and move it to you for that.
Okay.
There are SAP nodes which will be having programs. Yes, those coding change. That we need to give it to the technical. Okay. So country, I'll take English. Then language, again, there are different restricted languages only. SAP provides 41 types of language. Okay. Okay, shall we learn in Greek?
Greek?
No.
English.
Yeah.
If you both can speak it, it's great.
But what about you? You'll not understand.
I'm just kidding. Even I don't know. So, language is English. And the currency. Okay, again, currency is not an open field. This is your restricted. So, company so it provides 280 countries, but as I said, we can extend. We can extend country, language and currency by applying the SAP node app. So, in this case, applying SAP node means in the configuration. Now, I'll save it. When I save, system will ask for me a transport request. Okay. So, I'll create a new transport request for this particular project. Create request. ABC Private Limited. Okay. Now, when you go to a real-time server, apart from the short description, you have to update the project also. Every time you have to update which project it belongs to. But here it will not ask, it will not have any option. But in real time server, whether is a run project, whether is a development project, whether it is an enhancement project, every time they will update which project we are related to, so that they can segregate the PR. Whether it's a support project, whether it's a deployment project, whether it is a rollout project, whether it is an enhancement project, they will create different kinds of projects. Again, that depends on how they do practice. Some companies I have seen, they will not have any project. Everything will be stored. Okay, so purely depends. Some places I have seen, country-wise they create a project. For example, all that one country in India, okay, all the configuration of India should be done in one project. All the configuration in Middle East in one project. So in that country, they will have their support project, their deployment project, so everything they can do. So it again depends upon how they practice. Okay. Now when I click on save, internally system will create a transport request number. This range of transport request number will be given at the time of implementing, at the time of basis people, at the time of they are applying the SAP DVDs. Okay, when we purchase SAP software, okay, those comes in the DVDs. Those DVDs will be updated, those DVDs will be installed. So while installing the SAP, they will give a range. So system will pick automatically from that specific range. Now it has created request number, that is EH4K908101. Then click on continue. Then the device. Okay. Now for complete this ABC project, I will store every time in the same transport request. But when you go to the real time, again it depends upon the how they practice. Okay. In my experience, I have seen people for each node, one transport request. For example, let's say for defining company, one transport request. Define company code, one transport request. Define business area, one transport request. I have seen some projects where complete enterprise structure of FI, one transport request. Complete enterprise structure of your MM, one transport request. So again, it depends upon their process. Even I have seen where, like say, all the transport, all the enterprise structure related to MM, FIPP, everything will be stored in one transport request. So it depends. Okay. So suggestible is for your complete enterprise structure to create one transport request, so that what happens, you can move all the configuration at a time. Okay. So again, depends the project leader or person who are in the senior place, who drives the project. Okay, they do or discuss and they do decide. Now, company is defined, one step back, then define credit controlling area. Okay, go to new entries. I'll give AB01 credit control area. My currency. Okay, then the credit. Okay. Normally, credit control area, as I said, it is more of responsibility of sales and distribution. They have a specific topic that is called credit management. Okay, where they have to define a credit control area. But to complete the FI enterprise structure to make posting successfully, a company code must be assigned to a credit control area. Okay. Risk category, representative group, all these things they define. Whether how much risk is there. So now I'm defining at company code level, but in credit management of your SD, okay, they have a tool where they can each customer, based upon their credit process, they can give a credit limit, not to the complete company code. Okay, so credit management, which was more in sales and distribution, now credit management, slowly they are moving into FSCM. FSCM have a specific module, financial supply chain management, which deals more deeper in the credit management, which gives it more exposure to your credit management. Okay, but as of now, for FI perspective, update the identification, currency, and the credit limit. That means whenever I'm giving the credit to a customer, I cannot create any credit sales invoice more than this amount. Enter, then save, it will ask the transport request. But here if you see, the description field is inactive. So what we have to do, go to one step back, at credit control area and my company. And then I'll define the company code. We have a two process. One is copy, one is create. Copy process, I'll explain you in the last session. Okay, I will not do the copy process, we'll do the create process. Why create process? If you copy it, most of the implementation will do copy. I do agree. But if you copy it, you will not understand what are the things we have to do. There are a lot many configurations which will be copied automatically. So I'll show you the copy process in the final session, in the last session also. Okay, but now we will do the clear. Go to the edit company code, go to here. Let's say I'm giving the same identification what I've given for credit control area, AB01. I'll say ABC movies. Then the country, sorry, city, country, currency, language, then country. Okay, AB01 already exists. Okay, let me take AB90. Okay, these identifications, okay, whenever defining, okay, credit control area, business area, normally we give a separate identification. But as we are practicing to remember easily, I'll give most of the time configuration AB90, that is our company code identification. Then click on Control S, system will be populated new field, title. It's a company, doctor, Mr. or Mrs. I'll say this is related to. Then again, ABC Films Private Limited.
Movies Private
Third Limited. Term. Sorry?
It was ABC Movies Private Limited, right?
Yes. Movies, films, just I'm giving one item. Okay, oh, fine. Here I've given movies. Huh? Now, search term. Search term is another important feature, okay? If most of the time I have seen, for example, let's say they are coming from Oracle system to SAP, and Oracle system they have given some other identification. Let's say they have given 126 or 128 for this specific company code. So sometimes they do type that particular identification. Not only this, for your vendor, customer also every time will find a search term. So to remember to link to your legacy system. Okay, they will give the legacy system, that is your old system's identification. Sometimes we have seen like where from SAP to they link up the legacy system. Even though they are into SAP, they still use legacy system for a specific process where they are very comfortable, they don't want to change. Then how to link your customer, vendor or specific company code with your older legacy system, this search term they will use it. They will give the legacy system company code identification and here. And in the enhancement or in the customization, they will tell, okay, whenever you are searching for legacy system company code number, look for this particular field. The postings or the any transaction can happen legacy system to SAP, SAP to legacy system, we can build a connectivity system, we can build a interface and we can do. So some cases I've seen where they use the search term for the specific. Some companies they just give the identification itself. So it purely depends upon how we use the search term one and two. Then my street, let's say main road, house number, postal code, then the city, and that's it. Now we have an option here, for example, my address, length, or I want to give you more information, click on more pages. We can have more information too. Okay, so you can give more detail in the address information. Here another important thing to remember is international version. Okay, this is again used when you want to maintain the company code other than your English. Again, why it is used for any kind of announcement or any kind of your reporting purpose. So we want Katakana is one of the very commonly used when you go for your company codes in Asia specifically. Okay, so China, Japan, apart from their regular language, they use kanji and katakana very regularly. For any kind of information, they want the company code details. The company code details in kanji or katakana. Many of the bank interface I've seen, they want the information in katakana or kanji. They don't want in English. They do not support. Then you have to maintain based upon the requirement. If you want to maintain katakana, select katakana. And then in katakana language, you have to give the details. So it is again depends upon your requirement. Do you use international version very usually? Yes. Not only Asia specific, there are Mexican companies also I've seen they want in different languages.
No, by Kashi, by giving international versions, you give it in English only, so it gets converted into katakana language.
No, international language, you have to give it in katakana language.
Okay, somebody will assist you.
Okay, yes, somebody, the user, they have to give the details, you need to copy paste.
Okay.
So it will be in a kanji script, and you just have to copy paste.
Correct. Copy paste. Okay. That's what we have done. It that user has given us the details, and we have updated it. So kanji and katakana, which widely we have used when I was in my previous implementation. Most of the banks they have asked south part of your China, they ask katakana. Your middle part they ask kanji.
Even Japan is exclusively kanji scripted, right?
Yes, Japan is also exclusively for your kanji script.
Okay. What about a country India version then? Do we have anything like that?
No. For India, English is the standard format, obviously.
Okay. All but what about CIN version then? It comes under
SIN,
this or?
SIN is a tax process. This
okay.
Country India process, that is for tax. That is okay. Not your this version, that particular like name version.
Okay,
then continue and save. So your company coding. Then one step back from here. You cannot go one step back, close this, define business. Okay. New entries, I'll give AB80 for Mumbai, AB81 for Delhi, AB82 for Hyderabad, AB83 for Bangalore. So four business areas, okay, two for your north, two for your south. Then I'll maintain that consolidated business area. Okay, I'll give ABS1. Okay, south, consolidated business area, AB. N1, not consistent. So under ABS1, Hyderabad and Bangalore will come. Under ABN1, Delhi and so my F5 perspective, 5 detonation, 5 enterprises which is required, that is created. Now I'll create the relationship between this enterprise structure, or we call it assignments. Go to assignment, financial accounting, assign company code to company. Why we assign company code to company? Because company code is a lower organizational unit, company is a higher organizational unit. Then we have assigned company code to credit control area. Why we assign company code to credit control area? Because credit control area is defined at client level, and client is the highest hierarchy. Then assign your business area to consultant business.
And
company code to
Kashi, yes. The fifth one, assign profit center to company code. Profit yes. center
that
is more of controlling, isn't it?
Controlling. But we have an option to assign assign the profit center to company code also. But why it is considered as a FI not in controlling? Because business area not in view. That's what actually
okay.
I was
saying. Yeah. Okay.
That business area consolidation business area we do not use. That's why. So when you go for the implementation, normally what happens, they do not do FI, they do all FI controlling everything.
Okay.
Correct. But here, as you are learning, so first you have to do FI, then you have to do the controlling, so that you will get a exact flow of how it information flows.
Okay.
But in real terms of what happens that, okay, we do FI controlling all together. We do not do like module wise or module to sub module.
Okay.
Then assign company code to company. Go to position, Okay, give me 1 minute. Someone is talking better. I'll just check.
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah. So first, FN company, code to company, position works like a control F button. Now click on that and search your company code, AB9. So next to your company code, type your company. If you do not remember, go to the Dropbox. You can find all the company code which you have created. So we have created AB1000. Then control. Then assign company code to credit control area. Same. Go to position, type your company code. So I have given company code, credit control area, same identification. Ignite your company code, type the, no, AB01 I have given, sorry. Credit control area I have given, AB01, type your credit control. So when you are practicing, like write it down, the maintain in Excel, what are the things you are defining, because once it is created, it is very difficult to search what you have created using your EID, okay, using your login ID. So initially try to maintain the same identification. If you are maintaining a different identification, write it down in Excel so that you can remember. Then assign business area to consulted business area. Okay, so AB80 Mumbai, that is ABN1, Delhi also ABN1, Hyderabad ABS1, okay. So Mumbai, Delhi belongs to North, Hyderabad and Bangalore belongs. So from F5 perspective, the enterprise structure is done. Okay. So what are the items you have done? In the definition, company, credit control area, company code, business area, business area. In the assignment, assign company code to company, assign company code to credit control area, assign business area to.
Okay.
Any questions here?
No. No.
First few sessions, we have to go a little slow so that you will get a very clear picture. That's why I'm taking very slow, trying to give more examples. But after a couple of sessions, we will be going more faster. Okay.
Okay.
So, we'll keep it up to here today. We'll meet tomorrow and we'll look for another important one, financial accounting global settings. Those configurations works throughout your, that those configurations are very important. All other modules also dependent upon those configurations. Okay, that is called your financial accounting and global
settings. Okay. Also, Kashi, I was just looking in one of the document, it said, for company code, the T code is EC01, but I think it looks like it is OX2.
No, EC01 also is there.
Okay.
EC01 also one of the T code. Okay, where we can copy it, not create it.
Okay.
Okay. So if you want to copy, then your EC01 will be used. Okay, if you see, I'll show you. SPRO. Okay. Here we have two options, copy delete, to go to copy delete, EC01.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Copy delete option is your EC01. As I said, most of the people, they do EC01, but I don't want to do EC01. I want to manually create so that you link everything.
Okay.
So most of the people, they do the copy, but copy person, what happens, you will not find lot many processes, lot many things, by default it will copy, then you will not able to learn those things. So that's why we'll go create manually each one, create GL accounts. It is little difficult, but trust me, that is the best way to find.
So in real time, they would copy the company code from the standard available, or they'll create
It depends. It again, see, when I started in my career, like I have been working with my seniors, for the same seniors, he always suggests us to create.
Okay.
Few of my friends I've seen, like they practice that, they copy from the standard.
Okay.
Then they do the modification. Okay. So it depends upon like how they practice. Copy, if you are very, see, if you are not confident that when you copy, what are the items will be copied, because on the background there are lot many things are there which this system will copy. If you know all those things, we suggest go for create, because the things which are not required will not be copied.
Okay.
But when you are copying, everything is copied in the future, okay, you don't know, you have to keep deleting, okay, this is not required, this is not required. So when I started, like 6-7 years back when I started, like my seniors with whom we have worked, he has like almost at that time 10 years of experience, so he always suggests us to create. So even if we have 130 company codes, I do remember we manually went created 111, we did not copy. He always suggested the number ranges to copy and chart of depreciation to copy, rest all we created manually.
So there can be so many company codes, 130.
Yes, I have done an implementation where we have 335 company codes.
Okay, that's so quite a lot.
We can have lot many company codes. So, if it as I said, it will be lesser company codes, more company codes. So, it purely depends. So the implementation which I have done for 335, for they have like almost every country, they have two branches, and every country, those branches to every big countries, okay, they have 7-8 branches. For each branches, they have transactions, they do the payment, they do the income. So for each one, we have to do it, and that they own an asset. So they want a specific report for their particular location only, so we have to do it, that is for
330. Okay.
Okay.
So it can be, it is nothing strict that it has to be 10, 15 or 20, 30, it can be anything. All my implementation, every time, it's 100 plus company code driving.
Okay.
Or support as well. Fine girls, then practice these two topics. Practice, I think Murli has provided you server details, everything.
Yeah,
I'm going to get it.
You check your email ID. Yesterday actually I informed Murli, Murli said he will provide.
Okay, fine.
If not, send a mail to Murli or call him, because first three topics you have to practice a lot. If you are very good in first three topics, rest all topics will be very easy.
The first three topics, you mean to say the company and all that, or the next three classes?
Yeah, enterprise structure, financial accounting, global setting, general ledger setting.
Okay.
If these three topics, I'll say before go to a sample document, these three topics, you must show me minimum 20 company codes for these three. then only I'm starting with sample data.
Okay.
Because first three topics you are comfortable, apart from asset accounting.